Hello Galactic Family. Welcome aboard. Gaia Planetary Station is happy that you like the messages and information we communicate. Help the channel to grow by subscribing, commenting on the video, sharing, becoming a member and donating to the channel. We always appreciate good energies and vibrations. We are together in this new era ground crew, stay strong. Victory of Light. Hello Galactic Family. Greetings beloved angels in form, walking on hallowed ground of the new earth in the making. We see you as holiness in progress, exploring deep purpose and forgiveness in this time. This one has been having ascension symptoms presenting as spine pain for over a week, as have many of you. Be encouraged, for your etheric wings are strengthening in the gusts of the energetics that surround. You are growing stronger, wiser, braver, bolder. Your light is rising up as the surrounding darkness dissipates with the light. Purple wings envelop. Utilization of the violet flame in this time is essential. It will promote forgiveness, cleansing, and internal healing. Each internal healing sends ripple effects into the collective for the increase of the collective sum of healing. External frequencies are bombarding Gaia, your earth plane, transforming a higher reality construct by the moment. You are being recalibrated by this light. The darkness must be released from this world's reality, and it will, and it has been, and it will be. I, Zankiel, surround you with my violet flame, my violet wings. Feel this cocoon of light and the love and care for you that surrounds. All is unfolding as it should, as it must. Your etheric wings are growing stronger, your will more resolute. You must forgive that which has occurred on your world in order to heal it. I am the angel of forgiveness. It is much easier to avoid confrontation of such emotions. It is a seasoned warrior who can see it, heal it, and release it through the process of forgiveness. But you dear ones, are the seasoned warriors of both old and future timeliness embodied here now to assist, to lend energy and to heal. You are not alone in this. We of the angelic realm are offering you our divine wisdom and support, our abilities and insight. We surround you now with our light. Feel our wings beating with love and healing frequencies of which forgiveness resides. Be compassionate with yourselves and each other in this time of healing and rebirth. To be reborn, the old must die away. This is what you are seeing. The tyranny is at its end. I am Archangel Zankiel. Peace. We are the Seraphim Collective. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Holy, holy, holy is this hallowed time of creation. Holy, holy, holy are those who would offer their energy streams in this now. Holy, holy, holy is this most sacred moment of rebirth. Gaia is being reborn. Humanity is healing and in process. Holy, holy, holy is this most sacred of moments as the light embodied transcends the darkness and is elevated further up, up into the unknown realms of light. Bliss has been forgotten in this realm, but it is returning. The spirit remembers the call for home. Home is coming here within the higher dimensional vortexes that carry the vibration of home and soothe and comfort a weary warrior. Unknown light will be remembered. And yet Gaia will surpass all expectations. Already this has been done. Already the light workers have surpassed their own vows of assistance and faith. Already the warriors have laid down their weaponry and transformed them into plowshares for rebuilding. Your realm is catching up. Time is fluid. Dimensions shift like ripples in a pond. The ripples extend and extend. Your acts of kindness are immeasurable for the ripple onwards for eternity. So too this ascension of the planetary, personal and collective, is creating ripple effects through the cosmos, touching all the hardened and enlightened hearts, touching all the adjoining universes, rippling through the totality of Source. Can you see your importance in this process? Can you see your value? We see your value. Holy, 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 is this moment of cosmic ascension, for the all extends to the many as all are one. You, precious ones, are us in form. Many of you are Elohim, angelic, masters of old and future realms returned. You need not be hardened by your current circumstance. Feel the cosmic juice that fills you, that ripples through you into the many, touching us where we sing in the higher dimensional echelons of praise, for in our realm all is praise, for all has been transcended. The dark ones are being immersed in light and are being removed. They are being recycled into yet more light, and the wounds they made will be healed. The wounds they left will be filled with light, with liquid gold of Source light. I am seeing cracks in pottery being sealed in gold. We are the Seraphim Collective. Do not be downhearted. Do not be troubled. Feel the light and love that surrounds. Feel the cosmic force that is within you and all around you, and be solid in this knowing. Holy, 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 is this moment of your human embodiment, a sacred venture. I am seeing a mother brush her child's hair, a couple holding hands, being stuck in traffic, studying for a test. I am seeing the mundane and simple moments being filled with pleasure and awe. It is awe-inspiring that you are here. It is a holy moment. Master Yeshua said the same. Many masters speak. Few listen. They are returning to offer further wisdom. You will know. There is no superiority, all is light. Speak your words with love, find your truth and speak it. When the time is right, you will know. Holy, holy, holy is this moment of healing. Intend healing for your world and watch the ripple effect extend. I am seeing a silvery pond of clear water, watching ripples extend, all is affected. Galaxy Girl, do you understand? If even one light worker was not here, there would be significantly fewer ripples. Holy are you, beloved ones, for embodying in this time. We are the Seraphim Collective. We breathe on you now, and we see your woundings with our many eyes of all colors and sizes. Be seen. Be healed. Accept our blessing of love for you. We bless you as you bless the whole. In gratitude, we are the Seraphim Collective. Channel Galaxy Girl. We welcome a new energetic month that was introduced by the harmonic frequency of Libra at the end of March. A frequency that is reinforced by the main energies of April, which is one of completion, and the peace that comes when we have finally ended a challenging process, especially of the healing process that we initiated with Pisces, and that is now over. For we now pass to rebirth, renew, and empower ourselves under Aries, as there is a time for all within creation, and the time now to begin blossoming into the wondrous creators that we are and that we are here to master, has finally come. A time for us to begin a process of redirecting our lives towards the authentic path that we so desire to experience, and that due to our fears, doubts and many other things that we use as an excuse not to move forward, sometimes impede us to fully experience our true potential and real destiny, as even though there is never a final destination, there is always a lot that our souls wishes to create in this human plan, and that we, deep within our heart, know what it is. During this month, as we are seeing as the year progresses, more will begin to awake, as this is the time their soul planned for them to begin the process of conscious integration, and hence personal evolution. It is now when we, even though may have already experienced the same, most need to be compassionate, as they will begin the process of longing, of their home, which is simply the divine love that they have yet to find within, as well as all they now are remembering, and that have been hidden from them for so long and is now coming into the surface. A process of remembering when we miss something that we do not really know what it is exactly, but that after a time of walking on this path, we know that it is unity, the one that we have with all within creation, and that due to the many programs, and the veil of forgetfulness that we all choose to have when we incarnate, impeded us to see the truth. This is when the most need of our own experience, assistance, and unconditional love, for they only need compassionate witness and support, without judgments, as they continue rediscovering themselves, ending a cycle in which they believed they were just humans. For it is not easy to release an old self and its beliefs. This is spiritually called resurrection, for it is when we transcend who we used to be, without the need to physically die, and begin to embody our illumined self. To confirm the ending of a cycle, April is a universal number 9 inches numerology. Number 9 indicates transformations, endings, and hence, new beginnings, with the following transfiguration that comes when we awake our consciousness and pass from a lower state of being into a higher one. Number 9 is a confirmation of the beginning to the very end, of the completion of a cycle. It invites us to let go of everything that is not serving our higher purpose, until we empty ourselves, until we create the inner space to allow this new frequency to invade our entire being. As I always say, we are a forever ending beginning anew within this eternal cosmic spiral. For we never end, on the contrary, we are just beginning to discover the many realms that exist within creation, and its infinite wisdom. Number 9, in perfect synchronization with what we have been experiencing during March and its Piscean energies, is represented in the tarot by the Hermit, which is giving us the message to be wise, move inward, and like the Hermit, focus on our inner light truth to walk among the shadows until we reach the new shore, using only our inner light as the only compass to navigate through our current reality, for we need nothing more to be able to discern which way is aligned with our true self and which one does not serve any longer. And even if the path of solitude is not always easy, it is essential to listen to our inner divine guidance, before giving birth to this new reality, in which, we have already a higher aspect of us dwelling in it. This is where we still find ourselves at the moment, into a path of constant integration, of the wisdom that our soul holds within and that we continue decoding, as we evolve, step by step. A process of wisdom embodiment that requires times for us to rest, heal and clear ourselves, so we can continue with this endless process. This is why it is so important to align with the current energies from Aries, because it is with this sign that we purify ourselves, through the element fire now, and begin to rebirth from the ashes of our old self into the illumined essence of who we truly are. It is with Aries that we have the opportunity to empower ourselves to begin the process of becoming sovereign beings. However, to do so, first we need to heal our roots, and hence first chakra and our Kundalini energy, which correlates with Aries, of fears, especially survival ones, as well as many other wounds that come through eons of human slavery and lies. An energy that is empowered by Mars and that will give us vitality and strength to continue releasing what is needed, before embracing our sovereignty. At a cosmic level, we begin the month by having Mercury in Aries, on April 3rd. This is about focusing on the power of our word and personal beliefs. How we communicate with the world, and with ourselves, remembering that there is always a further communication that goes beyond the physical one, as we can all connect through the power of our hearts, for we dwell in many invisible dimensions, where communication is done through the heart and mind. A few days later, on April 6th, we have another wonderful cosmic alignment for us to focus on healing, as the more we evolve the more that we will need to be constantly updating our beliefs, and learn how to work with new energies that we did not use to, when we possessed a lower level of consciousness. This is a time for expanding on healing and for the ones who have already done their inner work and have reached a harmonic inner phase, begin to integrate new healing techniques so they can assist others who, like them, are now beginning this evolutionary journey. On April 9th, we have Saturn trine true node. This is all about our true soul mission, our destiny and what is yet to come. This is why taking responsibility for every moment, and the intention and creation that we put in it, is pivotal, because our next moment and what we will experience in it, will depend on what we do in our present one. This aspect is asking us to move out of our comfort zone and if we really desire to step into a new path, to leave behind all fears, doubts and everything that is impeding us to evolve and expand into new horizons, that may not be known but that is what we are meant to experience next in our human journey. This is call for all who are procrastinating to stand tall in who they really are, doing what they know they came here to do and be. Saturn trine true node is the frequency that for those who are ready to descend more aspects of their soul mission will help them receive more guidance about their soul purpose. For there are many who are already under this process of consciously unveiling more about their cosmic heritage and the many missions they have fulfilled, within creation, and the one they have been assigned, during this present lifetime. For others, this process of knowing more about their human mission will come when they will be ready to fully understand who they truly are. There are many precious souls who are passing, at this moment, through an inner transition in which for more than they desire to know, their human self is not ready yet, and only inner work, and patient, will help them, until they are ready to receive this new knowledge about who they are and what they are meant to do here on this planet. On April 11th, there is a new moon in Aries, that will bring vitality after having the last new moon in Pisces, where rather than focusing our energy and acting and constantly manifesting, we move inward to commune with our soul to regain clarity, one that will serve us now to begin a new path, for all is ready for us to create the path that we wish to travel. This is a time for us to rebirth from the depths of our being and with the proper wisdom regained, begin to act upon our projects and desires, which does not necessarily has to be about physically manifesting, but about simply shifting into a more loving and peaceful state of being. On April 14th, Venus enters Taurus. The planet of love and abundance in Taurus is going to be focused on the things we most value in the physical, our relationships and friendships, our creative essence and everything that involves bringing all the love we have within into our tangible plane. As everything, if we distort this essence, we can fall into the egoic trap of being possessive of material things and or people in our life. This is why creating a balance and practicing not getting attached to anything or anyone is pivotal when we have the planet of love and abundance in Taurus. It is always an opportunity for us to begin understanding that in truth we possess nothing and that authentic love is about letting all free and simply focusing on enjoying the co-creation until it is meant to come to an end. On April 19th, Mercury in Taurus will show us where we need to create more harmony and equilibrium in our tangible lives, for our existence is not just to dwell in the ethereal remembering who we truly are, but to also be practical and descend into the physical all we have created in the non-physical. Mercury in Taurus is a wonderful time to believe in ourselves, personal skills, especially verbal ones, and put ourselves and personal truth out there. After all, everything that is in our mental plane, shall be descended into the tangible, as it is where we express ourselves. On April 19th, the Sun will enter into the earthly sign of Taurus. The second sign of the zodiac, ruled by Venus, offers us the gift to create our heaven on earth, connecting with nature, honoring our physical realm and enjoying who we are and our creations. Taurus will start opening the energetic gates for us to begin grounding ourselves as well as our desires in the physical. With Taurus comes our second initiation into a deeper knowledge of how to manifest our desires from an energetic plane into our dense world, teaching us our next lesson within the wheel of life, which is to master ourselves in the endless art of bringing things from our inner world into our human one. Taurus is indeed a sign that likes to see the rewards of all his efforts. It invites us now to pay more attention to earthly matters, as they are the materialization of that which is within and that which sustains us in our lives, remembering that material things are also a part of our lives, for we do not separate anymore, as instead, we choose to unify all as being equal within creation. It is a time to create, to bring forth new desires now that we are about to enter into May. A time to be reborn just as nature does, as everything is giving birth to a new way of existing and so are we. We should stay open to receive all that we have been creating from within during all these months, and be patient, as everything has been already perfectly orchestrated for us to just have faith and trust that at divine timing, all that is meant to come into our lives, will come. April 23rd, Mars enters Cancer. The warrior in loving Cancer will teach us to be merciful and to be compassionate towards others, for we are all here to learn, in our unique way and time, unconditional love and the true nature of our essence. This is an opportunity for us to direct all of our energy and power into becoming the most powerful force of the universe love. April 26th, Full Moon in Scorpio. In the midst of this season of constant action and manifestation, with Scorpio comes an invitation for us to stop and go within to delve deep into our feelings, to see if all we are creating deeply resonates or it was created impulsively. It is important, especially at this time, in which many are overwhelmed by what they believe to be chaotic, to connect with our feelings and find peace so we can re-emerge again with more strength, clarity and a new way of looking at things. At many times when we act robotically, we tend to repeat old habits, and therein, obtaining the same old results. This is why it is so important to stop, take time to discern and regain mental balance, before stepping into a new creational phase. At the end of the month, on April 27th, Pluto will turn retrograde. As you know, I do not foment this human illusion of retrogrades in my articles, as I think it will not serve to continue fomenting old beliefs. Pluto's main essence is related to how we manage our personal power, which has nothing to do with our limited view from Earth. This is something that we all need to work with at this precise time when we seem to have been literally disempowered by outer forces and isolated. On the contrary of what it may seem, we all have the power to create, from within, to continue expanding and to manifest any outcome or state of being that we desire. The mistake, if I can call it as such, is to fall into the fake or illusory view that we are powerless at this time. The essence of Pluto will act as a reminder that we are sovereign beings and that no one can ever command our inner space, and hence, what we create outside of it. April is a month to transcend limitations and begin to open ourselves to experience a new reality. One where love has triumphed and we are now living the life that is aligned with who we are. Transcend who you are not. Let go of the illusion of who you are and embrace your true self, free of limitations, lies, fears. The choice to embrace this conscious process of inner metamorphosis, in which we embrace the shadows, traverse the corridor that leads us into this new life and finally rest into the peaceful remembrance of who we truly are, is always ours. A new dimension has become part of your being. Last week, we, of the universes, discuss giddiness and unusual life sparkle. Such is so because you are discovering what was once difficult has become easy. And that those you disliked or felt uncomfortable with have little meaning in your life. This new you is the result of the energies floating about the earth encouraging, even demanding, that you accept you in all your glory. In 3D, You were not supposed to be too great or grand. And if or when you felt as if you could do anything, someone or something made certain you could not. Your 3D limitations were designed to keep you under control. Fear is not possible when you have nothing to lose, including your standing in society. The parameters established by 3D society were designed to instill fear. A fear that even the most competent 3D leaders felt. For without followers, a leader could not maintain his or her outer directed power. In turn, those controlled by a leader were concerned they would be ostracized or lose their power if that leader no longer protected them or lost their power. 3D was a fear-based society. Fear can only be removed when there is no need to please or follow others. When your inner knowingness is enough to maintain your being in all activities and interactions. When self-love is as important as placating others. When you know without a doubt, you are as capable as any person. Such attributes were not honored in 3D, for fear does not encourage anyone to think highly of themselves. You have stepped into the realm of self-love and, therefore, self-activation. No longer do you need to wonder if this action or that activity is socially acceptable. Given that freedom, creations will be developed by anyone and everyone. No longer are there exceptions to this rule. The new being you birthed expects to be different in both actions and creations. New will be the word of the aeons. Simultaneously, interventions by those in control will be either ignored if they are of 3D or redirected if they are from those beyond 3D. For new you has no interest in others telling you what you can or should do. This is a time of radicalization, not in terms of harming others, but instead of fully claiming yourself. And by so doing, claiming the skill sets you developed in other dimensions and frequencies. You are no longer of 3D and no one can force you to return to those restrictions. Of course, those fully of 3D will attempt to do so. For how can they be powerful if no one is following or fearful of them? What is becoming evident to you foreigners is that those fully of 3D are acting more and more like a two-year-old. Stamping their feet and saying no to anything that might disrupt their power expectations. But just as is true for the two-year-old you interacted with or parented, those tantrums mean little. A two-year-old does not determine when they go to bed or what they eat even though they might want such to be so. You, the adult, perhaps laugh a bit and continue with your day. And if that means the two-year-old must go to bed, he or she will. So it will be with those enmeshed in 3D. They will test your boundaries, your will. You will respond by smiling or ignoring them as you go about your day. Their temper tantrums mean little in terms of your day or life. Outer-directed 3D power has ended. Even so, some foreigners will accept 3D fear for a bit until those foreigners realize their inner power. So it is you are beginning to realize you are not like most people. The same will be true for each foreigner, maybe not today, but very soon. And for once, you will not be ashamed or feel guilty about that difference, for your time has come. Allow those of 3D to display their temper tantrums for they are frightened. Not necessarily of your inner power, but because you do not need them to tell you who you are and what you are capable of. You have walked out of your 3D fear cell, and they have no idea how to bring you back. Their 3D power is as limited as that of a two-year-old. Some of you may feel the need to pretend you concur with those 3D beings until even that becomes too onerous. Just know that new you is a creative loner without a need for someone telling you what to do, when. There will be creative pods, if you will, of like-minded people. But those pods will not follow nor accept an overlord. Those days are over. An empath is a natural nurturer. The light in the darkness here to lead others to heal. Empaths are the wounded healers whose aura reflects their suffering. This can draw the wrong people, many narcissists to you like a moth to a flame. These type of relationships are draining and difficult for the sensitive, compassionate empath. Learning to ground, clear and protect are the vital shields of protection required on your journey. Each empath's gifts are unique, yet in many ways similar, with qualities that can assist you in discovering the key to your often muddled emotions. The aha moment of your journey, the moment you realize who you are on a soul level, opening to self-discovery of the lessons you are here to embark on. Realizing that the changing roller coaster moods are not all yours, we are magnets until we learn to ground, clear and protect our energies each and every morning prior to arising. The doubts you feel about yourself actually increase your compassion, your empathic nature. The compassion you share from your heart with others returns to you many times greater. There is power in recognizing aspects of who you are, as you become aware of your profound nature, your gifts. Those struggling to understand their sensitive nature, as an empath, a highly sensitive person HSP, your journey to understanding can bring a great sense of relief. With knowledge, you more easily maneuver through life, as you the learn to ground, clear, protect your gift, through morning meditation. You gain knowledge to both recognize and enhance the beautiful qualities you were given. Empaths sense feelings and emotions of others that often feel as if they are their own. A sensitive's mood can change drastically in a moment when someone with negative emotions enters, confusing the untrained empath. You can learn to scan and interpret your feelings to determine which are yours from those that are not. As you discover accepting your gifts, as you begin working through the challenges of this lifetime here on planet Earth, our classroom, for higher conscious awareness, you begin to feel more comfortable, a greater sense of self-awareness, of who you are, and why you are here at this time. The corner puzzle piece of self-knowledge, the starting point of all successful puzzles. A valuable lesson as you work through various situations, continually self-examine that you are not absorbing the negative energies. To gain information as you progress that will lead you to further understand your gifts. Once you gain knowledge and accept your gifts, this creates an easing of the negative emotions you have attached, assisting greatly in feeling more comfortable within your skin. Your enhanced perception can teach you to steer your life and set goals, once you recognize who you are. Intuitive empath. An empath possesses the ability to sense when others are uncomfortable or troubled. The gift to sense emotions does not imply that you must always do something. Others may need to reflect on their own feelings, their own situation as part of their core lesson. Restraint through self-awareness is necessary to avoid straining your sensitive system as you often try to fix others' problems, as they seem so apparent to you. Healthy boundaries are a necessity for sensitives, as, without them you can hamper your own progress. Remain cognizant of your emotions while you learn to decipher the origin, and release daily what is not yours. It may seem hard to imagine that you are capable of feeling someone else's true feelings, but indeed you are. For no matter what words they may have spoken, you hear beyond their capability, you hear the truth. Do not absorb these feelings, they are not yours. Observe with compassion, but maintain your emotional stability. The hidden power of solitude. Our journey of self-discovery during our awakening is a search of who we are, of our purpose, and the process of letting go. This is an inward solitary path, for it is in solitude we are unmasked, raw, yet comforted and still in the embrace of this union with our true self. Solitude is our refuge, where we listen to our needs, a valuable tool for all empaths. An inner world where we go to rejuvenate, nourish, and strengthen our connection not only to ourselves but with all. A place where we are comforted, embraced by the oneness of a higher source. A time where the distractions, the noise of the external are in slumber. In solitude, the mind gains strength and learns to lean upon itself. Lawrence Stern's solitude is often incorrectly aligned with isolation, yet they are very different. For isolation is rarely a choice, as it grows out of our unresolved issues that unknowingly can become a place one marinates in these negative feelings, often birthing feelings of loneliness and abandonment by life. In solitude you choose to enlist this comforting act, knowing this is a necessary tool of self-love. As solitude replenishes the body, mind and soul, where isolation only diminishes. In life, to make the right choices, one must be in touch with their soul, their higher power, the original light. We do this through the essential nurturing experience of solitude, which can be a scary thought for many who fear the silence, the unknown, yet, this is where we hear the truth, the solutions to our questions as we begin to awaken. A place where we are shown choices, to no longer live our life by the illusion of fate, to change our story, rewrite the life we desire, as nothing in life is finite. The empowering benefits of solitude creates an environment for self-discovery, assists in recovering from life's daily challenges. For sensitives, this is a must. A feeling of internal balance and peace centers you from the daily overstimuli, energizes both your body and your mind, awakens the creative force within, finding comfort in your own presence, without feeling lonely, increased focus and direction here. Within that silence, subtle feelings and intuitions awaken and guide us to what is true. And more to feed, be patient, it takes time to become comfortable with silence, but know, it is here you recover, find inner strength, and connect to the truth of your soul. The long-forgotten joy and peace of silence is our soulful maintenance birthright. It is always ready to embrace us in its blanket of stillness, wisdom and grace. Solitude is the gift we give ourselves, a place where one is inspired, transcending the noise, where all creativity is birthed. Our very soul is comforted, healed, reconnected to the one source, our inner home of spiritual solitude. A place where our divine connection, void of the human distractions that often breed isolation. As you grow insights, baby steps are still steps forward. Recognize with gratitude your gifts, gain an enlightened perception. Understanding your gifts will assist greatly. Learn to discern your emotions from others. Embrace the valuable gift of daily meditation, a relaxing 6-minute meditation to center, clear, and cleanse your chakras. With this quick daily meditation, you balance using these various frequencies of sound and color. Watch or listen in the evening before dream time, or in the morning when you awake, to relax, recharge or retune your inner being, your life force. As the 5 minutes prior to sleep is when you set the tone for your slumber. When negative thoughts about your day, or tomorrow emerge, you stew in them for 8 hours. Just a thought. Along the path of personal growth, self-discovery, you unite with the emotional body as an empath. As you become more comfortable in who you are, you soon understand why your gift is so vital. Your sensitive, loving, compassionate heart is a vital piece of the ascension puzzle. Honor who you are. As you bring peace internally, you bring peace to others. May all embrace with gratitude the gifts given from the original light, seen with an enhanced perception. As you recognize your place during this age of Aquarius, a beautiful gift once delivered is still in need of unwrapping. Honored light workers, light warriors, truth seekers, healers of Mother Earth and more. It can now be so frustrating for you, not to mention anything else. The needle you go through of lies, injustices and untruths that you also want to implement in humanity. You see it, you are awake and you know what truths must come to light before we can bring about change. So frustrating, dear ones. A symbolic image we can send you is as if you were teenage parents of children who choose drugs and you can just watch and try to awaken and give them rehabilitation, but your teenagers choose again and again to take the drugs that do not show the truth as it is but rock their minds in illusory veils, where they think they feel good even though they do not really do it at all. Unfortunately, we have to tell you that it will take time. The veils must be pulled away step by step, and since the dark forces know that this is their only chance to maintain control over you, it is just before the veils are pulled away. It is impossible for them to have control over you. You are already too high vibrating and see-through, feel when there is false information and you are terribly dangerous. Many are now expected on this page who must go over because the refraction becomes too great and too powerful for their soul to handle. It may feel like a small consolation, but you will receive confirmation from them in various ways from this side that they now understand that you were right. They will see life on Earth with a completely different perspective from this side. When they were incarnated on the ground, they were so identified with matter that it became impossible to see reality in any other way than what was offered in false areas. The drama is right now both terrible and fantastic to watch, and as above so also below. Now that your DNA strands have opened up to your true self and the crystalline forms have been activated, it can be even more strenuous and tiring for you to see the inertia and fatigue that those still lingering in the third dimension are rubbed in. We also see that you feel more alone than ever, and that you are seen as fools and chairs does not make it easier. Your work is so magnificent and difficult to extinguish, so we ask you from here to see your beauty and sacred pursuit. We humbly bow to your work effort and know that we actually cooperate. At night we take care of you, and at certain particularly difficult times you may lie in our healing chambers for the restoration of energy and potent light. If you feel tired and worn out, ask our ships to receive you before you go to sleep so that you can even, with a conscious will, let us receive your spiritual body. In your heart, you are free. This energy of freedom can be expressed in your daily life as well as kept as a sacred trust within you. This energy is God working through you and encouraging you to let your light shine. When you are feeling free to be yourself, that is the time your light shines the brightest. That is when you are most relaxed and happy, which is the way your spirit intended you to live. When you let your light shine in the world, darkness is illuminated. The parts of society that offer the greatest challenge are the ones needing the most light. Allowing God's love to pour through you as divine light is one of the best ways to create the changes you want in your world. This energy of love-filled light can bring wholeness and healing to any situation. When you come to this place of light within you, it reminds you of the joyous state of a happy child. You are being encouraged to express this joyous energy in your family and worldly life. It is the spontaneous freedom to speak the truth from your heart with kindness and compassion. It is the enthusiasm to do what you most want to do, knowing that you are divinely inspired in every moment. These are the gifts you are being asked to give to the world. Experience the freedom of divine light at work within you. Feel free to ask for so much love to come through you that you can let it overflow to others. Ask for abundant joy within you so that you can share it. Ask to speak your highest truth with the compassion of the angels. Ask to know in your heart that which is right for you to do and say in every moment. Ask to be a vehicle for divine light moving into the world. Now let it enter into your personal field. When you allow yourself to receive the gifts that come from your prayers, it gives you perfect freedom of expression while knowing the divine resources within you at all times. You are a gift to the world when you express all of the beauty inside you. Share your most sacred self when you feel the guidance to do so. Allow God's light to shine through you and remember. Greetings, beloved angels in form. walking on hallowed ground of the new earth in the making. We see you as holiness in progress, exploring deep purpose and forgiveness in this time. This one has been having ascension symptoms presenting as spine pain for over a week, as have many of you. Be encouraged, for your etheric wings are strengthening in the gusts of the energetics that surround. You are growing stronger, wiser, braver, bolder. Your light is rising up as the surrounding darkness dissipates with the light. Purple wings envelop. Utilization of the violet flame in this time is essential. It will promote forgiveness, cleansing, and internal healing. Each internal healing sends ripple effects into the collective for the increase of the collective sum of healing. External frequencies are bombarding Gaia, your earth plane, transforming a higher reality construct by the moment. You are being recalibrated by this light. The darkness must be released from this world's reality, and it will, and it has been, and it will be. I, Zankiel, surround you with my violet flame, my violet wings. Feel this cocoon of light and the love and care for you that surrounds. All is unfolding as it should, as it must. Your etheric wings are growing stronger, your will more resolute. You must forgive that which has occurred on your world in order to heal it. I am the angel of forgiveness. It is much easier to avoid confrontation of such emotions. It is a seasoned warrior who can see it, heal it, and release it through the process of forgiveness. But you dear ones, are the seasoned warriors of both old and future timeliness embodied here now to assist, to lend energy and to heal. You are not alone in this. We of the angelic realm are offering you our divine wisdom and support, our abilities and insight. We surround you now with our light. Feel our wings beating with love and healing frequencies of which forgiveness resides. Be compassionate with yourselves and each other in this time of healing and rebirth. To be reborn, the old must die away. This is what you are seeing. The tyranny is at its end. I am Archangel Zankiel. Peace. We are the Seraphim Collective. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Holy, holy, holy is this hallowed time of creation. Holy, holy, holy are those who would offer their energy streams in this now. Holy, holy, holy is this most sacred moment of rebirth. Gaia is being reborn. Humanity is healing and in process. Holy, holy, holy is this most sacred of moments as the light embodied transcends the darkness and is elevated further up, up into the unknown realms of light. Bliss has been forgotten in this realm, but it is returning. The spirit remembers the call for home. Home is coming here within the higher dimensional vortexes that carry the vibration of home and soothe and comfort a weary warrior. Unknown light will be remembered. And yet Gaia will surpass all expectations. Already this has been done. Already the light workers have surpassed their own vows of assistance and faith. Already the warriors have laid down their weaponry and transformed them into plowshares for rebuilding. Your realm is catching up. Time is fluid. Dimensions shift like ripples in a pond. The ripples extend and extend. Your acts of kindness are immeasurable for the ripple onwards for eternity. So too this ascension of the planetary, personal and collective is creating ripple effects through the cosmos, touching all the hardened and enlightened hearts, touching all the adjoining universes, rippling through the totality of Source. Can you see your importance in this process? Can you see your value? We see your value. Holy, holy, holy is this moment of cosmic ascension, for the all extends to the many as all are one. You, precious ones, are us in form. Many of you are Elohim, angelic, masters of old and future realms returned. You need not be hardened by your current circumstance. Feel the cosmic juice that fills you, that ripples through you into the many, touching us where we sing in the higher dimensional echelons of praise, for in our realm all is praise, for all has been transcended. The dark ones are being immersed in light and are being removed. They are being recycled into yet more light, and the wounds they made will be healed. The wounds they left will be filled with light, with liquid gold of source light. I am seeing cracks in pottery being sealed in gold. We are the Seraphim Collective. Do not be downhearted. Do not be troubled. Feel the light and love that surrounds. Feel the cosmic force that is within you and all around you, and be solid in this knowing. Holy, holy, holy is this moment of your human embodiment, a sacred venture. I am seeing a mother brush her child's hair, a couple holding hands, being stuck in traffic, studying for a test. I am seeing the mundane and simple moments being filled with pleasure and awe. It is awe-inspiring that you are here. It is a holy moment. Master Yeshua said the same. Many masters speak. Few listen. They are returning to offer further wisdom. You will know. There is no superiority, all is light. Speak your words with love, find your truth and speak it. When the time is right, you will know. Holy, holy, holy is this moment of healing. Intend healing for your world and watch the ripple effect extend. I am seeing a silvery pond of clear water, watching ripples extend. All is affected. Galaxy girl, do you understand? If even one light worker was not here, there would be significantly fewer ripples. Holy are you, beloved ones, for embodying in this time. We are the Seraphim Collective. We breathe on you now and we see your woundings with our many eyes of all colors and sizes. Be seen. Be healed. Accept our blessing of love for you. We bless you as you bless the whole. In gratitude, we are the Seraphim Collective. Channel Galaxy Girl. We welcome a new energetic month that was introduced by the harmonic frequency of Libra at the end of March. A frequency that is reinforced by the main energies of April, which is one of completion, and the peace that comes when we have finally ended a challenging process, especially of the healing process that we initiated with Pisces, and that is now over, for we now pass to rebirth, renew, and empower ourselves under Aries, as there is a time for all within creation, and the time now to begin blossoming into the wondrous creators that we are and that we are here to master, has finally come. A time for us to begin a process of redirecting our lives towards the authentic path that we so desire to experience, and that due to our fears, doubts and many other things that we use as an excuse not to move forward, sometimes impede us to fully experience our true potential and real destiny, as even though there is never a final destination, there is always a lot that our souls wishes to create in this human plan, and that we, deep within our heart, know what it is. During this month, as we are seeing as the year progresses, more will begin to awake, as this is the time their soul planned for them to begin the process of conscious integration, and hence personal evolution. It is now when we, even though may have already experienced the same, most need to be compassionate, as they will begin the process of longing, of their home, which is simply the divine love that they have yet to find within, as well as all they now are remembering, and that have been hidden from them for so long and is now coming into the surface. A process of remembering when we miss something that we do not really know what it is exactly, but that after a time of walking on this path, we know that it is unity, the one that we have with all within creation, and that due to the many programs, and the veil of forgetfulness that we all choose to have when we incarnate, impeded us to see the truth. This is when they most need of our own experience, assistance, and unconditional love, for they only need compassionate witness and support, without judgments, as they continue rediscovering themselves, ending a cycle in which they believed they were just humans. For it is not easy to release an old self and its beliefs. This is spiritually called resurrection, for it is when we transcend who we used to be, without the need to physically die, and begin to embody our illumined self. To confirm the ending of a cycle, April is a universal number 9 inches numerology. Number 9 indicates transformations, endings, and hence, new beginnings, with the following transfiguration that comes when we awake our consciousness and pass from a lower state of being into a higher one. Number 9 is a confirmation of the beginning to the very end, of the completion of a cycle. It invites us to let go of everything that is not serving our higher purpose, until we empty ourselves, until we create the inner space to allow this new frequency to invade our entire being. As I always say, we are a forever ending beginning anew within this eternal cosmic spiral. For we never end, on the contrary, we are just beginning to discover the many realms that exist within creation, and its infinite wisdom. Number 9, in perfect synchronization with what we have been experiencing during March and its Piscean energies, is represented in the tarot by the Hermit, which is giving us the message to be wise, move inward and, like the Hermit, focus on our inner light truth to walk among the shadows until we reach the new shore, using only our inner light as the only compass to navigate through our current reality. For we need nothing more to be able to discern which way is aligned with our true self and which one does not serve any longer. And even if the path of solitude is not always easy, it is essential to listen to our inner divine guidance, before giving birth to this new reality, in which, we have already a higher aspect of us dwelling in it. This is where we still find ourselves at the moment, into a path of constant integration, of the wisdom that our soul holds within and that we continue decoding, as we evolve, step by step. A process of wisdom embodiment that requires times for us to rest, heal and clear ourselves, so we can continue with this endless process. This is why it is so important to align with the current energies from Aries, because it is with this sign that we purify ourselves, through the element fire now, and begin to rebirth from the ashes of our old self into the illumined essence of who we truly are. It is with Aries that we have the opportunity to empower ourselves to begin the process of becoming sovereign beings. However, to do so, first we need to heal our roots, and hence first chakra and our Kundalini energy, which correlates with Aries, of fears, especially survival ones, as well as many other wounds that come through eons of human slavery and lies. An energy that is empowered by Mars and that will give us vitality and strength to continue releasing what is needed, before embracing our sovereignty. At a cosmic level, we begin the month by having Mercury in Aries, on April 3rd. This is about focusing on the power of our word and personal beliefs. How we communicate with the world, and with ourselves, remembering that there is always a further communication that goes beyond the physical one, as we can all connect through the power of our hearts, for we dwell in many invisible dimensions, where communication is done through the heart and mind. A few days later, on April 6th, we have another wonderful cosmic alignment for us to focus on healing, as the more we evolve the more that we will need to be constantly updating our beliefs, and learn how to work with new energies that we did not use to, when we possessed a lower level of consciousness. This is a time for expanding on healing and for the ones who have already done their inner work and have reached a harmonic inner phase, begin to integrate new healing techniques so they can assist others who, like them, are now beginning this evolutionary journey. On April 9th, we have Saturn trine true node. This is all about our true soul mission, our destiny and what is yet to come. This is why taking responsibility for every moment, and the intention and creation that we put in it, is pivotal, because our next moment and what we will experience in it, will depend on what we do in our present one. This aspect is asking us to move out of our comfort zone, and if we really desire to step into a new path, to leave behind all fears, doubts and everything that is impeding us to evolve and expand into new horizons, that may not be known, but that is what we are meant to experience next in our human journey. This is call for all who are procrastinating to stand tall in who they really are, doing what they know they came here to do and be. Saturn trine true note is the frequency that for those who are ready to descend more aspects of their soul mission will help them receive more guidance about their soul purpose. For there are many who are already under this process of consciously unveiling more about their cosmic heritage and the many missions they have fulfilled within creation and the one they have been assigned during this present lifetime. For others, this process of knowing more about their human mission will come when they will be ready to fully understand who they truly are. There are many precious souls who are passing, at this moment, through an inner transition in which, for more than they desire to know, their human self is not ready yet, and only inner work, and patience, will help them, until they are ready to receive this new knowledge about who they are and what they are meant to do here on this planet. On April 11th, there is a new moon in Aries, that will bring vitality after having the last new moon in Pisces, where rather than focusing our energy and acting and constantly manifesting, we move inward to commune with our soul to regain clarity, one that will serve us now to begin a new path, for all is ready for us to create the path that we wish to travel. This is a time for us to rebirth from the depths of our being and, with the proper wisdom regained, begin to act upon our projects and desires, which does not necessarily has to be about physically manifesting, but about simply shifting into a more loving and peaceful state of being. On April 14th, Venus enters Taurus. The planet of love and abundance in Taurus is going to be focused on the things we most value in the physical, our relationships and friendships, our creative essence and everything that involves bringing all the love we have within into our tangible plane. As everything, if we distort this essence, we can fall into the egoic trap of being possessive of material things and or people in our life. This is why creating a balance and practicing not getting attached to anything or anyone is pivotal when we have the planet of love and abundance in Taurus. It is always an opportunity for us to begin understanding that in truth we possess nothing, and that authentic love is about letting all free and simply focusing on enjoying the co-creation until it is meant to come to an end. On April 19th, Mercury in Taurus will show us where we need to create more harmony and equilibrium in our tangible lives, for our existence is not just to dwell in the ethereal remembering who we truly are, but to also be practical and descend into the physical all we have created in the non-physical. Mercury in Taurus is a wonderful time to believe in ourselves, personal skills, especially verbal ones, and put ourselves and personal truth out there. After all, everything that is in our mental plane shall be descended into the tangible, as it is where we express ourselves. On April 19th, the Sun will enter into the earthly sign of Taurus. The second sign of the zodiac, ruled by Venus, offers us the gift to create our heaven on earth, connecting with nature, honoring our physical realm and enjoying who we are and our creations. Taurus will start opening the energetic gates for us to begin grounding ourselves as well as our desires in the physical. With Taurus comes our second initiation into a deeper knowledge of how to manifest our desires from an energetic plane into our dense world, teaching us our next lesson within the wheel of life, which is to master ourselves in the endless art of bringing things from our inner world into our human one. Taurus is indeed a sign that likes to see the rewards of all his efforts. It invites us now to pay more attention to earthly matters, as they are the materialization of that which is within and that which sustains us in our lives, remembering that material things are also a part of our lives, for we do not separate anymore, as instead, we choose to unify all as being equal within creation. It is a time to create, to bring forth new desires now that we are about to enter into May. A time to be reborn just as nature does, as everything is giving birth to a new way of existing and so are we. We should stay open to receive all that we have been creating from within during all these months, and be patient, as everything has been already perfectly orchestrated for us to just have faith and trust that at divine timing, all that is meant to come into our lives, will come. April 23rd, Mars enters Cancer. The warrior in loving Cancer will teach us to be merciful and to be compassionate towards others, for we are all here to learn, in our unique way and time, unconditional love and the true nature of our essence. This is an opportunity for us to direct all of our energy and power into becoming the most powerful force of the universe love. April 26th, Full Moon in Scorpio. In the midst of this season of constant action and manifestation, with Scorpio comes an invitation for us to stop and go within to delve deep into our feelings, to see if all we are creating deeply resonates or it was created impulsively. It is important, especially at this time, in which many are overwhelmed by what they believe to be chaotic, to connect with our feelings and find peace so we can re-emerge again with more strength, clarity and a new way of looking at things. At many times when we act robotically, we tend to repeat old habits, and therein, obtaining the same old results. This is why it is so important to stop. Take time to discern and regain mental balance, before stepping into a new creational phase. At the end of the month, on April 27th, Pluto will turn retrograde. As you know, I do not foment this human illusion of retrogrades in my articles, as I think it will not serve to continue fomenting old beliefs. Pluto's main essence is related to how we manage our personal power, which has nothing to do with our limited view from Earth. This is something that we all need to work with at this precise time when we seem to have been literally disempowered by outer forces and isolated. On the contrary of what it may seem, we all have the power to create, from within, to continue expanding and to manifest any outcome or state of being that we desire. The mistake, if I can call it as such, is to fall into the fake or illusory view that we are powerless at this time. The essence of Pluto will act as a reminder that we are sovereign beings and that no one can ever command our inner space, and hence, what we create outside of it. April is a month to transcend limitations and begin to open ourselves to experience a new reality. One where love has triumphed and we are now living the life that is aligned with who we are. Transcend who you are not. Let go of the illusion of who you are and embrace your true self, free of limitations, lies, fears. The choice to embrace this conscious process of inner metamorphosis, in which we embrace the shadows, traverse the corridor that leads us into this new life and finally rest into the peaceful remembrance of who we truly are, is always ours. A new dimension has become part of your being. Last week, we, of the universes, discussed giddiness and unusual life sparkle. Such is so because you are discovering what was once difficult has become easy. And that those you disliked or felt uncomfortable with have little meaning in your life. This new you is the result of the energies floating about the earth encouraging, even demanding, that you accept you in all your glory. In 3D. You were not supposed to be too great or grand. And if or when you felt as if you could do anything, someone or something made certain you could not. Your 3D limitations were designed to keep you under control. Fear is not possible when you have nothing to lose, including your standing in society. The parameters established by 3D society were designed to instill fear. A fear that even the most competent 3D leaders felt. For without followers, a leader could not maintain his or her outer directed power. In turn, Those controlled by a leader were concerned they would be ostracized or lose their power if that leader no longer protected them or lost their power. 3D was a fear-based society. Fear can only be removed when there is no need to please or follow others. When your inner knowingness is enough to maintain your being in all activities and interactions. When self-love is as important as placating others. When you know without a doubt, you are as capable as any person. Such attributes were not honored in 3D, for fear does not encourage anyone to think highly of themselves. You have stepped into the realm of self-love and, therefore, self-activation. No longer do you need to wonder if this action or that activity is socially acceptable. Given that freedom, creations will be developed by anyone and everyone. No longer are there exceptions to this rule. The new being you birthed expects to be different in both actions and creations. New will be the word of the aeons. Simultaneously, interventions by those in control will be either ignored if they are of 3D or redirected if they are from those beyond 3D. For new you has no interest in others telling you what you can or should do. This is a time of radicalization, not in terms of harming others, but instead of fully claiming yourself. And by so doing, claiming the skill sets you developed in other dimensions and frequencies. You are no longer of 3D and no one can force you to return to those restrictions. Of course, those fully of 3D will attempt to do so, for how can they be powerful if no one is following or fearful of them? What is becoming evident to you foreigners is that those fully of 3D are acting more and more like a 2-year-old. Stamping their feet and saying no to anything that might disrupt their power expectations. But just as is true for the 2-year-old you interacted with or parented, those tantrums mean little. A 2-year-old does not determine when they go to bed or what they eat, even though they might want such to be so. You, the adult, perhaps laugh a bit and continue with your day. And if that means the 2-year-old must go to bed, he or she will. So it will be with those enmeshed in 3D. They will test your boundaries, your will. You will respond by smiling or ignoring them as you go about your day. Their temper tantrums mean little in terms of your day or life. Outer-directed 3D power has ended. Even so, some forerunners will accept 3D fear for a bit until those forerunners realize their inner power. So it is you are beginning to realize you are not like most people. The same will be true for each forerunner, maybe not today, but very soon. And for once, you will not be ashamed or feel guilty about that difference, for your time has come. Allow those of 3D to display their temper tantrums, for they are frightened. Not necessarily of your inner power, but because you do not need them to tell you who you are and what you are capable of. You have walked out of your 3D fear cell, and they have no idea how to bring you back. Their 3D power is as limited as that of a 2-year-old. Some of you may feel the need to pretend you concur with those 3D beings until even that becomes too onerous. Just know that new you is a creative loner without a need for someone telling you what to do, when. There will be creative pods, if you will, of like-minded people. But those pods will not follow nor accept an overlord. Those days are over. An empath is a natural nurturer, the light in the darkness here to lead others to heal. Empaths are the wounded healers whose aura reflects their suffering. This can draw the wrong people, many narcissists to you like a moth to a flame. These type of relationships are draining and difficult for the sensitive, compassionate empath. Learning to ground, clear and protect are the vital shields of protection required on your journey. Each empath's gifts are unique, yet in many ways similar, with qualities that can assist you in discovering the key to your often muddled emotions. The aha moment of your journey, The moment you realize who you are on a soul level, opening to self-discovery of the lessons you are here to embark on. Realizing that the changing roller coaster moods are not all yours, we are magnets until we learn to ground, clear and protect our energies each and every morning prior to arising. The doubts you feel about yourself actually increase your compassion, your empathic nature. The compassion you share from your heart with others returns to you many times greater. There is power in recognizing aspects of who you are, as you become aware of your profound nature, your gifts. Those struggling to understand their sensitive nature, as an empath, a highly sensitive person HSP, your journey to understanding can bring a great sense of relief. With knowledge, you more easily maneuver through life, as you the learn to ground, clear, protect your gift, through morning meditation. You gain knowledge to both recognize and enhance the beautiful qualities you were given. Empaths sense feelings and emotions of others that often feel as if they are their own. A sensitive's mood can change drastically in a moment when someone with negative emotions enters, confusing the untrained empath. You can learn to scan and interpret your feelings to determine which are yours from those that are not. As you discover accepting your gifts, as you begin working through the challenges of this lifetime here on planet Earth, our classroom, for higher conscious awareness, you begin to feel more comfortable, a greater sense of self-awareness, of who you are, and why you are here at this time. The corner puzzle piece of self-knowledge, the starting point of all successful puzzles. A valuable lesson as you work through various situations, continually self-examine that you are not absorbing the negative energies. To gain information as you progress that will lead you to further understand your gifts. Once you gain knowledge and accept your gifts, this creates an easing of the negative emotions you have attached, assisting greatly in feeling more comfortable within your skin. Your enhanced perception can teach you to steer your life and set goals, once you recognize who you are. Intuitive empath. An empath possesses the ability to sense when others are uncomfortable or troubled. The gift to sense emotions does not imply that you must always do something. Others may need to reflect on their own feelings, their own situation as part of their core lesson. Restraint through self-awareness is necessary to avoid straining your sensitive system as you often try to fix others' problems, as they seem so apparent to you. Healthy boundaries are a necessity for sensitives, as, without them you can hamper your own progress. Remain cognizant of your emotions while you learn to decipher the origin, and release daily what is not yours. It may seem hard to imagine that you are capable of feeling someone else's true feelings, but indeed you are. For no matter what words they may have spoken, you hear beyond their capability, you hear the truth. Do not absorb these feelings, they are not yours. Observe with compassion, but maintain your emotional stability. The hidden power of solitude. Our journey of self-discovery during our awakening is a search of who we are, of our purpose, and the process of letting go. This is an inward solitary path, for it is in solitude we are unmasked, raw, yet comforted and still in the embrace of this union with our true self. Solitude is our refuge, where we listen to our needs, a valuable tool for all empaths. An inner world where we go to rejuvenate, nourish, and strengthen our connection not only to ourselves but with all. A place where we are comforted, embraced by the oneness of a higher source. A time where the distractions, the noise of the external are in slumber. In solitude, the mind gains strength and learns to lean upon itself. Lawrence Stern. Solitude is often incorrectly aligned with isolation, yet they are very different. For isolation is rarely a choice, as it grows out of our unresolved issues that unknowingly can become a place one marinates in these negative feelings. Often birthing feelings of loneliness and abandonment by life. In solitude you choose to enlist this comforting act, knowing this is a necessary tool of self-love. As solitude replenishes the body, mind and soul, where isolation only diminishes. In life, to make the right choices, one must be in touch with their soul, their higher power, the original light. We do this through the essential nurturing experience of solitude, which can be a scary thought for many who fear the silence, the unknown, yet, this is where we hear the truth, the solutions to our questions as we begin to awaken. A place where we are shown choices, to no longer live our life by the illusion of fate, to change our story, rewrite the life we desire, as nothing in life is finite. The empowering benefits of solitude creates an environment for self-discovery, assists in recovering from life's daily challenges. For sensitives, this is a must. A feeling of internal balance and peace centers you from the daily overstimuli, energizes both your body and your mind, awakens the creative force within, finding comfort in your own presence, without feeling lonely, increased focus and direction here, within that silence, subtle feelings and intuitions awaken and guide us to what is true. And mortal fee, be patient, it takes time to become comfortable with silence, but no, it is here you recover, find inner strength, and connect to the truth of your soul. The long-forgotten joy and peace of silence is our soulful maintenance birthright. It is always ready to embrace us in its blanket of stillness, wisdom and grace. Solitude is the gift we give ourselves, a place where one is inspired, transcending the noise, where all creativity is birthed. Our very soul is comforted, healed, reconnected to the one source, our inner home of spiritual solitude. A place where our divine connection, void of the human distractions that often breed isolation. As you grow insights, baby steps are still steps forward. Recognize with gratitude your gifts, gain an enlightened perception. Understanding your gifts will assist greatly. Learn to discern your emotions from others. Embrace the valuable gift of daily meditation, a relaxing 6-minute meditation to center, clear, and cleanse your chakras. With this quick daily meditation, you balance using these various frequencies of sound and color. Watch or listen in the evening before dream time, or in the morning when you awake, to relax, recharge or retune your inner being, your life force. As the 5 minutes prior to sleep is when you set the tone for your slumber. When negative thoughts about your day, or tomorrow emerge, you stew in them for 8 hours. Just a thought. Along the path of personal growth, self-discovery, you unite with the emotional body as an empath. As you become more comfortable in who you are, you soon understand why your gift is so vital. Your sensitive, loving, compassionate heart is a vital piece of the ascension puzzle. Honor who you are. As you bring peace internally, you bring peace to others. May all embrace with gratitude the gifts given from the original light, seen with an enhanced perception. As you recognize your place during this age of Aquarius, a beautiful gift once delivered is still in need of unwrapping. Honored light workers, light warriors, truth seekers, healers of Mother Earth and more. It can now be so frustrating for you, not to mention anything else. The needle-eye you go through of lies, injustices and untruths that you also want to implement in humanity. You see it, you are awake and you know what truths must come to light before we can bring about change. So frustrating, dear ones. A symbolic image we can send you is as if you were teenage parents of children who choose drugs and you can just watch and try to awaken and give them rehabilitation, but your teenagers choose again and again to take the drugs that do not show the truth as it is, but rock their minds in illusory veils, where they think they feel good even though they do not really do it at all. Unfortunately, we have to tell you that it will take time. The veils must be pulled away step by step, and since the dark forces know that this is their only chance to maintain control over you, It is just before the veils are pulled away. It is impossible for them to have control over you. You are already too high vibrating and see through, feel when there is false information and you are terribly dangerous. Many are now expected on this page who must go over because the refraction becomes too great and too powerful for their soul to handle. It may feel like a small consolation, but you will receive confirmation from them in various ways from this side that they now understand that you were right. They will see life on Earth with a completely different perspective from this side. When they were incarnated on the ground, they were so identified with matter that it became impossible to see reality in any other way than what was offered in false auras. The drama is right now both terrible and fantastic to watch, and as above so also below. Now that your DNA strands have opened up to your true self and the crystalline forms have been activated, it can be even more strenuous and tiring for you to see the inertia and fatigue that those still lingering in the third dimension are rubbed in. We also see that you feel more alone than ever, and that you are seen as fools and chairs does not make it easier. Your work is so magnificent and difficult to extinguish, so we ask you from here to see your beauty and sacred pursuit. We humbly bow to your work effort and know that we actually cooperate. At night we take care of you, and at certain particularly difficult times you may lie in our healing chambers for the restoration of energy and potent light. If you feel tired and worn out, ask our ships to receive you before you go to sleep so that you can even, with a conscious will, let us receive your spiritual body. In your heart, you are free. This energy of freedom can be expressed in your daily life as well as kept as a sacred trust within you. This energy is God working through you and encouraging you to let your light shine. When you are feeling free to be yourself, that is the time your light shines the brightest. That is when you are most relaxed and happy, which is the way your spirit intended you to live. When you let your light shine in the world, darkness is illuminated. The parts of society that offer the greatest challenge are the ones needing the most light. Allowing God's love to pour through you as divine light is one of the best ways to create the changes you want in your world. This energy of love-filled light can bring wholeness and healing to any situation. When you come to this place of light within you, it reminds you of the joyous state of a happy child. You are being encouraged to express this joyous energy in your family and worldly life. It is the spontaneous freedom to speak the truth from your heart with kindness and compassion. It is the enthusiasm to do what you most want to do, knowing that you are divinely inspired in every moment. These are the gifts you are being asked to give to the world. Experience the freedom of divine light at work within you. Feel free to ask for so much love to come through you that you can let it overflow to others. Ask for abundant joy within you so that you can share it. Ask to speak your highest truth with the compassion of the angels. Ask to know in your heart that which is right for you to do and say in every moment. Ask to be a vehicle for divine light moving into the world. Now let it enter into your personal field. When you allow yourself to receive the gifts that come from your prayers, it gives you perfect freedom of expression while knowing the divine resources within you at all times. You are a gift to the world when you express all of the beauty inside you. Share your most sacred self when you feel the guidance to do so. Allow God's light to shine through you and remember. Hello Galactic Family. Hello to all who like Gaia Planetary Station. I would like to thank you for being together to learn and grow the light. Improving every step and knowing that the energies of light are making an incredible cleaning of the universe and planet Earth is the great jewelry of this monumental change. All who are connected with their higher self must follow their own missions. Here I present some of the products of the store, search to see if you like something. For those who want to make donations to the channel by PayPal, we have the donation link to the channel. Subscribe to the channel, be a channel member, always comment on the videos and click on like button. Thank you for the amazing messages, the fun conversations and participations in the chat of the videos. I am happy that many warriors of light are together in this new age. May 2021 be incredible for everyone.